Anyhow, now the Devi reaches the Daksha's place. Daksha refuses the entry to Devi. And actually, one more thing, Devi shows all her powers to Shiva. Before enlightenment, after Satori, you will have a lot of powers. And you will have a tremendous arrogance about powers. That is what Devi shows to Shiva. See my powers. To whom she is showing? Who gave to them? She is showing. The person who gave the power, to him she is showing, see my glories. Dasamaha Vidya means 10 different powers she is showing. All kinds of powers. Anyhow, Shiva leaves and she comes to the Daksha, Daksha's Yajna, and Daksha says, stop, don't come inside. The moment ego hurts the ego, it will become too much. It will become too much. One more thing, when you are filled with ego, you do not even bother to look into the details. Actually, if Daksha could have been little more intelligent, he would have made Devi as a friend, because now Devi also gone against Shiva. He could have made Devi as friend, but the ego is such, it can never create more and more energy or power or friends. Be very clear, if you are egoistic, the basic truth will be, you will not have friends. You will be reducing the number of friends constantly. The basic quality of ego is becoming more and more exclusive. It will start exclude. Ego will never allow you to include. That's the quality of ego. If you start including, you will never be egoistic. Daksha did not include Devi. He disrespected. Daksha also has got an ego. Devi also has got an ego. But the difference is, Daksha's ego has never seen the egolessness. Devi's ego has seen egolessness at least once. Because of that, Devi left the body and became enlightened. You see, if your ego is given a shock, if you already meditated, you will enter into meditation only. But if you have never meditated, if you have never known something beyond ego, you will never even think there is some space beyond ego. Before, that's why I tell, before your death, have at least one conscious experience. Because when you die, you will enter only into that experience. You will not enter into the arrogance. Here, the ego of Daksha and ego of Devi, both are fighting. Both had a big clash. The ego of Daksha never understood he is doing something wrong. But the ego of Devi understood, realized she has done something wrong, because she has already seen the egoless space of Satori. Simply she decides to become enlightened and leaves the body and relaxes into enlightenment. I tell you, after Satori, whatever happens around you will be lesson teaching you. Before Satori, even if lessons are taught to you, you will only suspect the people who teach you. Before Satori, even when the master teaches, you will think, this fellow has got his own vested interest. That is why he goes on teaching. You will suspect only the master. After enlightenment, even if ordinary incidents happen in your life, you will learn the lesson from it. Lessons from it. After Satori only, you became student, disciple. Till then, you are only a observer, witness, never a person who learns, never a disciple. Now, Devi learnt the lesson from the life. The only engram which was left is the affection towards the parents. Now that is also lost. She doesn't need the body anymore. She said, let this body given by you be lost, enough. I do not want this body anymore. And she just relaxes, drops the body. She says, I have given what you gave me, take it. Throws it away, disappears and becomes enlightened. Relaxes into the cosmic intelligence. Now the next scene. Even after Devi learnt the lesson, Daksha did not learn the lesson. He did not learn the lesson. He never understood. He is continuing his homa. He did not even care to remove the dead body. He said, let it be lying down. You continue your homa. The homa continues. Now, the concern which overflows, the compassion which overflows from the master, that is called Veerabhadra. When master knows his disciple was disrespected, the tremendous concern overflows. Understand, I always tell people, whenever somebody disrespects me, I never care. I never bother. Because I know he will understand. But when somebody disrespects my disciples, simply you will be seeing I will be the first person to stand up. I myself will be shouting at my ashramites. But when somebody else shouts, I will catch their throat. And I will see that they disappear. And they just... I never allow that to happen. I never allow my disciples to be disrespected. When I put somebody as a leader, and if these guys question them, it's actually showing your arrogance to them so that you can't show it to me. You can't directly disrespect me, that is too much. So let us show where we can show. Let us send the message to Swami in an indirect way. They are cunning idiots. I always take them to task. Anyhow, that compassion that Devi was disrespected, even though Devi herself disrespected Shiva, but the compassion, because the disciple, the fight between Shiva and Devi is like a fight between master and disciple, that's okay. But he cannot allow the third person to enter into that. He cannot allow the third person to disrespect the disciple, even though the disciple himself did not respect the master. That is the compassion of the master. The whole compassion takes the form of Veerabhadra, the energy of Veerabhadra, with the sword of knowledge and the fire of anger. That is what is the Veerabhadra, the fire and the sword. He straight away lands, simply finishes the whole thing. The whole arrangement, all the people who came, everybody disappeared in 2 minutes. Everybody, when the compassion of the master, the concern for the disciple, if it overflows and comes out in the form of fire or anger, all these half connected or half disconnected disciples will run away, will escape. That is what this means. When the Veerabhadra landed, all the fellows disappeared. Only the Daksha was left, means the demon seeker. This story is beautiful. Now the Veerabhadra just cuts the head of Daksha, means he teaches the lesson by force. He finishes him off and puts that in the fire. Activity which he started out of arrogance, and that itself his ego was lost, means he became failure, finished. Next scene, the Vishnu, who was supposed to protect the planet Earth, he lifts the body of the Devi and puts it on the, actually the Veerabhadra takes the body and puts it at the feet of the Shiva, and Shiva just takes the body and starts walking. Now it is Vishnu's responsibility to cool down Shiva and take care of the planet Earth. Otherwise this anger, the whole world will disappear. When the master's energy is high, he doesn't care even about his mission. So it is Vishnu's work, means the first circle disciples work to maintain him and take care of the mission. Take care of the mission. So now Vishnu starts slowly cutting the body, and the body falls in 51 places. Means now this body is the relics of an enlightened soul. Now this body is the relics of the enlightened soul. So wherever that relics falls, that place becomes energy center. That place becomes energy center. When, and the next important point of the story, the disciple who became enlightened, Devi became enlightened, she asked Shiva now, because she became enlightened completely, she says, now I think we should forgive Daksha also. We should forgive Daksha also, because I know how much I suffered when I did tapas. When I left you and went to Daksha, I know how ego played on me, because I suffered by the ego. I know how much you would have suffered by that same ego. Now it is time you should forgive him. This is what? Another one dimension of master. He does tapas because he just want to know the difficulties of seekers, so that he will have the tremendous compassion towards the seekers. Now, because Devi asked, the story says, Shiva blessed Daksha. Daksha came back to life with a goat head. With a goat head. Understand, it means except his ego, everything was given back to him. Head is the representation of ego. That was taken back, taken away. And the goat head means, why goat head? You know, goat will always be shaking the head. Means saying yes to everything. The only problem Daksha had is he can't say yes to anybody. Now the only quality he has got is he will say yes to everybody. That is the transformation. It shows Daksha is now transformed. If that, just the quality of the one, that one quality of saying no, if it is removed, the same demon seeker will become enlightened master. Same demon seeker will become enlightened master, because master also has got all the qualities. He doesn't, he has achieved all the things of the outer world, and he looks beyond the things of the outer world. Only thing, he knows whatever he knows and what he doesn't know. Demon seeker will not know what he knows, what he doesn't know. Master will know what he knows and what he doesn't know, because of his intelligence to say yes. Now, the Daksha, who was killed by the compassion of the master, and one more thing, by the compassion of the master, nobody can be killed. They can only be transformed. That is what it means. Daksha was given the life back. Daksha was given the life back with a goat head, so that he will understand that saying no to life means saying no to life itself. He will understand how to say deep yes to the whole life. When he learned how to say a deep yes to life, not only he got the life back, he became enlightened. So just learn how to say yes to the life. Not only you will have your life back, you will become enlightened. Thank you. Let these stories and truth liberate you. Let you achieve and radiate eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.